Hello friends, welcome back to lecture series of Basic Electronics. In the previous video, we had discussed about PN junction diode. The diode allows the flow of current only in one direction, from anode to cathode, and it blocks the current in the opposite direction, from cathode to anode. That is the reason that diode is very useful in many applications like clipping, clamping and rectification. The process of rectification is to convert the AC power into DC power, and the circuit is used for the rectification is called rectifier. This rectifier can be classified into two different types. First one, that is half wave rectifier, and second one, that is full wave rectifier. So let us discuss both type of rectifiers in detail. But before we start, if you like the video, then click on like button and drop your comment. And to watch more videos, do subscribe to my YouTube channel Electrotech CC. Most of the electronics devices and circuits require a DC source for their operation. Dry cells and batteries are one of the form of DC source. They have the advantage of being portable and ripple free. However, their voltages are low. They need frequent replacement and are expensive as compared to DC power supply. Since the most convenient and economical source of power is the domestic AC supply, that is the advantage to convert this AC power to DC power. The process of converting AC power to DC power is called rectification and is accomplished with the help of rectifier, filter and voltage regulator circuits. So let us discuss the rectifiers. We will consider the following types of rectifiers. First one, that is half wave rectifier. Second one, that is full wave rectifier. And third one, that is bridge rectifier. So let us start with half wave rectifier. In the half wave rectifier, AC power supply is connected with a single diode. In the half wave rectifier, the supply of AC power source is connected to resistive load through a single diode. So in the positive half cycle of the input AC voltage, the diode is in forward bias. So it turns on and conducts. Diode acts as a short circuit so that current flows, and hence positive half cycle of the input AC voltage is dropped across resistive load RL. But in the negative half cycle, the diode is in reverse bias, so it turns off, and so it doesn't conduct. That's why there is no current, hence there is no voltage drop across RL. If there is no current, then the voltage drop across RL is equal to IL into RL, but the current through the resistive load is zero. That's why the voltage drop across RL is equal to zero. The output is not a steady DC, but only pulsating DC wave, having a ripple frequency equal to that of the input frequency. Since only positive half cycle of the input wave is used, it is called half wave rectifier. So let us discuss some of the important average value and RMS value for the half wave rectifier. First one, that is the input signal. Input signal is sinusoidal source, and it can be given as Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t. Here Vm is the maximum value of supply voltage and is equal to root 2 into V. V is the RMS value of supply voltage. So the average DC voltage across the load resistor is equal to Vm divided by pi and is equal to 0.318 Vm. The average DC current through the load is equal to average DC voltage across the load divided by load resistor and is equal to VDC divided by RL. If we simplify, then IDC that is the average DC current through the load is equal to 0.45V divided by RL. Next one, that is form factor. Form factor is the ratio of RMS value to the average value of output power. So it is equal to 1.57 for half wave rectifier. Next one, that is PIV, that is the peak inverse voltage for half wave rectifier. The maximum voltage across the diode in the reverse direction is equal to VM. That indicates peak inverse voltage for half wave rectifier. Next one, that is ripple factor, and is equal to VR, RMS divided by VDC, and is equal to 1.21. Next one, that is efficiency. It is the ratio of output power to the input power. For half wave rectifier, it is equal to 40.6%. Now let us discuss full wave rectifier. In the full wave rectifier, the main AC power supply is connected to load resistor through a transformer and two diodes. So, full wave rectifier circuit using two diode and center type transformer is as shown in the figure. Both half cycles of the input are utilized with the help of two diodes working alternately. Use of transformer is essential. Center tap is usually taken as the ground or zero voltage reference point. So, if we discuss the working of full wave rectifier, then in the positive half cycle, the input current is transferred in the output current with the help of center tap transformer. The output current flow through the diode D1 and RL resistive load in clockwise direction. So, in positive half cycle, the output voltage appear across RL is equal to the input voltage of positive half cycle. In the negative half cycle, the output current flow through diode D2 and resistive load RL in anticlockwise direction. So, the output voltage across RL is the input voltage of negative half cycle but with opposite polarity. So, current through RL is in the same direction. That's why the output voltage across RL is in the positive direction only. The output is not a steady state DC but only pulsating DC wave having a ripple frequency equal to twice of the input frequency. Now let us discuss average value and RMS value of voltage and current for full wave rectifier. Here Vs is the input voltage and Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t. The average DC voltage across the load resistor is equal to 2 into Vm divided by pi. If we simplify it, then it is equal to 0.636 Vm. And the average DC current through RL is equal to 2 into VDC divided by RL. Here, VDC is the average DC voltage across the load. So, average DC current through the load is equal to 0.636 into Im. Now let us discuss the form factor value for full wave rectifier. The form factor is the ratio of RMS value to the average value of output power and is equal to 1.11 for full wave rectifier. The peak inverse voltage for the full wave rectifier is the maximum voltage across the diode in the reverse direction and is equal to 2Vm. Here Vm is the maximum voltage across the half of the secondary winding. The ripple factor for full wave rectifier is equal to 0.482. And last one, that is the efficiency. For full wave rectifier, the efficiency is the output power to the input power and is equal to 81.2%. The last one point, that is full wave bridge rectifier. In the full wave bridge rectifier, the input power supply is connected to RL resistive load through bridge rectifier. Most frequently used circuit for electronics DC power supply is full wave rectifier. It requires 4 diodes, but the transformer used is not center tap and has maximum voltage of Vm. It is available in 3 distinct physical form. First one, that is 4 discrete diode. Second one, that is one device inside a 4 terminal case. And last one, that is as a part of array of diode in an IC. Now let us discuss the working of full wave bridge rectifier. Full wave bridge rectifier work in two different modes. First one, in the positive half cycle, the current flow through diode D1, resistive load RL and diode D3. In the positive half cycle, the output voltage is equal to input voltage in the same direction and current flow through positive to negative terminal. In the negative half cycle, the current flow through diode D2, resistive load RL and diode D4. Similar to positive half cycle, the current flow from positive to negative terminal in the same direction through resistive load, and the output voltage across the resistive load RL is equal to input voltage with opposite polarity, because the direction of current is similar as in positive half cycle. Full wave bridge rectifier, the output is not a steady state DC but only pulsating DC waveform having a ripple frequency equal to twice of the input frequency. Now let us discuss the average value and RMS value for full wave bridge rectifier. So the input voltage is equal to Vm sin omega t. The average DC voltage across the load is equal to 2 into Vm divided by pi for full wave bridge rectifier. If we simplify it, then VDC is equal to 0.636 Vm. Average DC current through resistive load is equal to 2 into VDC by RL is equal to 0.636 into Im. The next one value, that is form factor for full wave bridge rectifier. The value of form factor is equal to 1.11 for bridge rectifier. The peak inverse voltage is the maximum voltage across the diode in the reverse direction and is equal to 2 Vm for full wave bridge rectifier. The ripple factor for full wave bridge rectifier is equal to 0.482. The efficiency of full wave bridge rectifier is equal to 81.2%. So in this video, we discussed about different types of rectifiers. In the next video, we will discuss about filters.